Good evening, YouTube. I've been running my Tracer 4215BN solar charge controller with the 4S lithium-ion battery bank now for a couple of weeks, and finally got a nice clean trace here. So I wanted to show you how the various parameters are working and how I know it's a pretty dialed in set of parameters. So this is the real-time current here. So actually the load here, which is in blue, turned on about 6:30 this morning. So it was before I turned on the monitoring program. And then this is about 8:30 right here, where the sun hits the solar panels, and you can see the power starts going up at that point. So the green is the battery. So the battery was actually being discharged up until about 9:30 this morning. The charging current here in red is actually the current at the solar panel voltage. So you kind of have to multiply this by maybe not quite twice, because this is at like 28 to 30 volts, and this is at 15 or 16 volts. So anyway, you can see about 8:30 the solar current started going up, and the battery here, it was being discharged up until about 9:30, which is right here, and then for about another 2 hours it was getting charged in bulk charge mode. So for a lithium battery charger, this would be what you call the constant current charge. But of course, since it's a solar panel, it's not constant current. The solar charge controller is gradually increasing the voltage on the battery up until this point, and that's where it hits the charging limit voltage, which I have set at 16.1, and then that's where it transitions from bulk to boost charge. So that's this line right here, and I have that set up to do boost charge for 120 minutes or 2 hours. And you can see about here, that's about 1:30. Boost charge current was pretty much zero. That's your constant voltage charging. So you keep the voltage at the maximum voltage, and then the battery current drops and drops down towards zero. And then at that point, the 120 minute timer expired, and it goes into float charge. And what I do in float charge is I drop the charging voltage 100 millivolts, pulling a little bit of current out of the battery, then it puts a little bit back in, takes a little bit out, puts a little in, and it pretty much holds zero current into the battery. It's just holding it even, and then actually my PC went to sleep right in here, so I missed about an hour's worth of data. But then if you look here at the solar current, if I were to continue this line, red line, up and over and down, that would be peak power or current out of the solar panels if you just filled in that curve. And here it started dropping off to the point that the battery was being discharged because the solar panels couldn't keep up with the load. And then about here is when the load shuts off, and then the solar charge controller tries to recharge the battery again. So it's gone from float charge back to boost charge here. So I think everything's working pretty good, and the only real change I've done is I've increased the overvoltage cutoff. I had it set at 16.2, but I found that even on a normal day like today, the maximum voltage hit 16.28 just for a brief instant. That was probably right around here where it was at the peak charging current. A few days ago, there were some clouds blowing over in the morning, and I noticed on that day the maximum voltage I saw was 16.58. Again, that's just for a few seconds that it hits that high. But you can imagine, you know, if you're up here pulling full power out of your solar panels, and then all of a sudden the load drops to zero, or you have a cloud go over and then the current surges, that battery voltage is going to go up, for just a few seconds until the charge controller can back off like it did here. Right here, we've had quite a few clouds, kind of scattered clouds go over today, so there was a lot of kind of cloud edge effect. In fact, you can see one big pulse right there got up over around 12, almost 12 amps, which is my peak current from the panels I have. Yesterday I was doing kind of a full power run here. I had about 16 amps of load, and I was right at about 10 amps sustained for several hours. So I basically set the overvoltage cutoff to 16.8. I figured that's higher than I should ever normally see it, and 16.8 is the highest voltage that I could have on my 4S battery bank safely anyway, so I just figured move it up to the highest reasonable value and then just leave it there. And so what I'll do, I'll put a link in the video description down below here. I'll put a link to my folder on my Google Drive page, and I'll put a couple of files in there, and let me show you some of those here. Yeah, so I'll put a link to this folder on my Google Drive page, and what I've done here, I've got a number of files. I put together a README file that explains the settings.txt file format. So I've got that here. It describes the parameters and how to set them. And then I have my file for my 4S battery. This is a 4 volt per cell profile, so I have those current parameters. And then what I've also done is I've pulled the 3 and 6S lithium ion charging parameters out of the solar station monitor program, and then I have the 4S and 8S lithium iron phosphate profiles. So I've put all of those in there if you want to use those as reference. So anyway, I'll put that folder link in the video description down here, and if you have any questions or comments, post up in the comment section below that, and I'll put some follow-up videos over here on the left side you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching.